Ano? Eke? Hello YouTube. Welcome back to Toe Shifters. This is me, Kaushik. So today's day is pretty amazing actually. I'm just talking by the weather perspective. I don't know about anything else yet. The day's just started, so anyways, yeah, the weather is pretty good. It's clouded over. I think it might probably rain in the evening, so yeah, let's see how that goes. So today I'm just going to get my firefly serviced. If you guys can see here, the service has been coming. So actually, in fact, when we went to Vanavilas Dam, if you've seen the video of us riding to Vanavilas Dam after the lockdown reopened, you can just click the I button up there, or I'll drop a link in the description below to watch that video if you haven't watched it. So yeah, it was actually due for service since July, so it's either 1 year or 7,500 kilometers, whichever earlier. But in my case, I had barely done about 3,000 odd kilometers, or close to 3,000 kilometers, that's all, since the last service, because obviously since our last ride in December, I've not been to any rides because of the lockdown and things like that. So yeah, that was the reason that the bike wasn't run at all. And anyways, so it's better to change your oil every year, and we are also planning some ride towards the end of this year, somewhere around October or November. So let's see if that plans up. The bike has to be ready for that, right? So it's never a good idea to actually service your bike just before you start your ride. It's always better to service your bike probably a month or 15 days in advance, so that whenever you go out, if there is any issue, you still have the time to get it corrected or sorted out, right? So here, yeah, my bike has completed 3 years this July, so she's already 3 years old. This is a 2017 model, as far as you know. And KTM had extended 1 year warranty post their regular 2 years of warranty that they provide on their Jeeps. So I've completed the warranty, and the service in KTM has pretty decent, I wouldn't say it is too bad. They have been very good. In fact, I had to service it right here. So this is Maker Circle in Bangalore. So if people in Bangalore would definitely know the KTM right across the corner in Maker Circle. So that's where I used to go. And I used to take care of the bike really well. The service wasn't that bad at all. But yeah, I thought, let us just give it a try somewhere else. If they can extract anything better out of this bike, you never know, right? So that's the plan for today. Let's see how it goes. We're going to the place called Indimota, the Grease House. So I'll leave a link to them in the description as well. So they're scheduled, actually usually they take at least a day or two to service the bike, but it was me and Vikram, we're planning to service our bikes together at the same place. So we thought this time let's do it together at a common place and see how it goes. So just like my previous review, when I serviced my bike last time with the Nikki Molly power pack. If you haven't watched the video of the Nikki Molly power pack, suggest you to just click the I button right now to have a look at the video.
So just left the bikes at Indimota. It's been what, about 2 hours?
Yes,
so we left came, at, we came at about 10:30, and they started work on our bikes by about 11 o'clock or something. So yeah, they're just doing the service of our bikes, and it seems to be pretty detailed. Yes, in the way that they're looking at each and everything. Yeah, they're just looking at each and everything. So
and so far so good.
Yeah, they've been doing it good, so we'll only know once the things are done. So let's see how it goes. And it's about 1 o'clock now, and we guys are kind of getting a bit hungry. Yeah, so we thought we will just head out and go for lunch. So yeah, we chose Maxima oils this time, both of us. And the last one was Liqui Moly, as you guys must have seen in the vlog, the previous one. So now let's see how this oil performs, if it's any better than what we've been using.
Hopefully,
yeah. And with the way the work is being carried out, we do have some high expectations.
Yes, we do.
Just heading to this place called Best, somewhere 600 meters not really wanting to eat much, but you know, we are hungry, so we plan to take that risk. Being a Saturday, this place has really calmed down, and all of these areas is mainly dominated by all the IT companies. So since most of them are work from home, and since it's a Saturday anyways, it is not as crowded as it used to be. So it's pretty calm, and even this place is pretty chilled out. Okay, so we just came to this place, Brigade Metropolis. Yeah, so we are searching for this place called Best. We didn't know it was inside this, and we just spotted the Domino's boards outside, and we thought it's better to just play it safe and go to Domino's instead of going to some other place. So we came here and we found that all of these shops are here, but most of them are shut. So anyways, we just ordered them. They're not taking orders in store now, and you have to order it online. So what do you call it? Hands-free process, is it?
Yeah,
no, hands-free, touch-free.
No touch.
Touch-free.
Okay. Touch-free process.
Touch-free, whatever it is. Anyways, so yeah, we just played it safe and we just ordered. We are right by the store now. I think it should be ready in a few minutes, and we'll probably just sit here and finish our lunch and then head back to Endomotard. This place is really good. I mean, I would have seen better days than being deserted like you see it now. So yeah, the ongoing pandemic has hit everyone pretty hard. Yeah. Let's see, the wait for pizza, I hope it is not too long. Guys are really hungry. It's almost 2 o'clock now, yeah. Finally got our pizzas after about half an hour wait. We ordered for thin crust and they didn't have it. Yummy.
Oh yeah, it looks good.
After a long, I think after Jan or Feb, I think this is the first time after about 8 months that we're actually eating outside. And
the last time I went to Domino's is our Ooty ride.
Ooty ride, oh, that was delicious. Oh, seriously?
Yeah.
We also haven't been to any place after that. I don't remember, but it's been really, really long time, and we guys are really hungry. So, yes, we'll just start with our munching.
Yes.
Yeah, so finally, our monsters are ready. They're all serviced. Right here, my Firefly and Vikram Raven, the Dominar 400. So it was a nice work done by people at Endomotard here, and we chose the Maxima oils as I told earlier. So, and we did the Liqui Moly flush as well. So that has made quite a bit of difference on our bikes. So
yes,
Vikram's bike, as soon as it was cranked, I mean, we felt it definitely has made a difference. But obviously it is too soon to say anything about it. But yeah, for now, the bikes do sound really good. And with my bike, I've always been telling there is some kind of a rolling noise that I've been hearing. And now when they opened up the rims and they checked the bearings, there was quite a bit of an issue with that. So the bearings were gone, and the half axle or something that was totally rusted. So because of that, there was no grease, and hence the bike was not moving as freely as well. So those things are sorted and things look really, really good. And also there was some misalignment with the front forks, hence the bike was not going in a straight line. So luckily that thing is sorted as well. And with all the things sorted, I think we would probably give this place 4.5 stars out of 5. Definitely, I mean, the rest half of the star probably after 1,000 kilometers, we'll just add up to the review. So yeah, kudos to Endomotard for giving a wonderful service and a great hospitality. It's a nice place, you can definitely try it. I'll probably join a review after 500 kilometers of on both of our bikes and with this video, so it'll be a lot more better for people to decide. So I guess he'll just move out from now. Vikram has to go to a place called 6K Isle of Man. So he has he's planned to install a center stand on his bike. So
and we'll probably saddle stay.
Oh, saddle stay. Yeah. Yeah. So we're just going to get those works done. It's about 4 o'clock now, 4:30. So we might reach there in about half an hour.
Yeah.
And probably an hour's work there.
The servicing is done except for one thing, that is the service remote that's been coming. How we do it is go to preferences. Okay, don't select it. Press these two switches for about 3 or 5 seconds. Yes, and then you say next service in. The regular service interval is 7500. You say set. That's it. Done. Right. So now when you look at it here. Preferences, service 7500 and 9/2021, that is next year. So I'm good to go for another year. And Okay, so me and Vikram are connected now. And I hope you took everything, right? Wallet, yeah. Gloves, phone.
Nope.
Yeah, okay, seems good. And I hope guys at Indy Motard are good enough to give us back if we left something. So, yeah, all in all, a day well spent at Indy Motard. That had a cramp buster thing on the throttle. Thank you so much. Yeah, this little thing that you see right here. So basically this helps you on your longer rides. Not a big thing on a city rides, but just kind of used to it, resting my thumb on it. See, what a little bit of rain makes a mud out of Bangalore roads.
We've just come to this place at Kibraj Bajaj on Kasturba Road. The Isle of Man is right here, if you can see. So Vikram is getting installed his saddle stays and a center stand on his bike. He had actually already got the top rack the last time, and we had installed these from the Carbon Racing, the saddle stays, so he thought that might fit, so he didn't take it the last time. So he's getting those installed. Meanwhile, we have quite a few things to ogle at around here. And there seems to be some meet that is happening at Isle of Man. So there are a lot of bikers that are coming in. So these are the stays. So these would probably go something like this. Oh, this is the other side, I guess. Anyway, so that's what. So that is getting fixed and probably take about half an hour or so, and then he'll head home. See if we can attend the meet, what's happening there upstairs. Also, there is the husky standing right there, if you can see. It's really beautiful, and the adventure behind is so beautiful, so beautiful. Looks so good. Love the headlamp detail on this. Look at this. Humongous tires, really wide. I think they're probably 120 profile tires.
Yeah, 110.
110 is it? The same as our bikes, but so this is the SWAT pillion. Okay, yeah, this is the SWAT pillion. So this is a little. This is a rack, I think, on which you can probably put your bag or something. So this is a regular one, and you have a wet pillion, which is like a cafe racer. Yeah, really beautiful the way the bike is designed. I mean. Look at the console, it's really trendy. It resembles the likes of Ducati Scrambler to some extent. But obviously being a KTM engine, I mean, it's going to be really robust in terms of riding it for sure. And some Adventure 390. Very basic. Oh, it has the that
dog. Yeah.
With Mad Dog. LED lights, and it has this pannier mount from Carbon Racing. So this is that, these are actually made of fiber, and these are not that heavy, and these are actually pannier mounts. So something really good. Then backrest, not a fan of it. Finally the stand is fixed. This is the center stand here, as you can see. Then the saddle stays. Rigid now with the proper system. You can see there is no vibration. As we went last time, there was quite a bit of vibration. It is not fixed properly, and now it's all done. Now let's see if Vikram is able to put this on a stand. Vikram, kar bhai, zor laga ke hai gaya. Vikram, you can put a 18 inch wheel at the back now. हाँ गुड एडवेंचर राइडर वेरी गुड
इट इज रियली रियली बिग आई मीन इट टेक्स अप द बाइक क्वाइट अ हाइट आई मीन एंड ऑल्सो द ग्राउंड क्लियरेंस इज गॉन क्वाइट लो नाउ
Come on. Okay, so that's about it. Today's work is almost finished and the day is coming to an end. So I guess I will just end this video here. And if you guys are really interested in watching the review of my service with the Maxima oil, I think I'll be putting a short video on my Instagram, so do follow me on my Instagram. My Instagram ID should be showing up down here right now. So yeah, I guess I'll see you guys another day and another vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed today's vlog. If you did, don't forget to give this video a like and don't forget to subscribe to this channel if you're new. Until then, until the next video, ride safe, ride hard, always wear your safety gear, never go public wearing your helmet.